Hi friend, I'm Amy Auger from the FODMAP Formula, and today I want to talk about why your IBS symptoms get worse on your period. First, let's talk about what's actually happening in your body. Your ovulation cycle is controlled by a group of hormones created by the pituitary gland, the hypothalamus, and the ovaries. While everyone's a little different, the ovulation cycle is normally around 21 to 35 days and happens in three phases. The first phase is called the follicular phase, and it happens from day 1 to 14 of your cycle. This phase starts on the first day of your period as your body starts to shed the uterine lining, called the endometrium. This normally takes between 3 and 8 days. While your uterus is busy doing that, your pituitary gland releases a hormone called follicle stimulating hormone, or FSH. This hormone tells the ovaries to produce a number of follicles, each of which contains one egg. Over the next few days, one follicle will become dominant and the others will start to shrink back into the ovary. The final follicle will continue to develop a mature egg. On day 12 of your cycle, the follicle will release a burst of estrogen that travels through the bloodstream to the pituitary gland. Your pituitary gland will then release luteinizing hormone, or LH, to help the follicle increase in size. The estrogen will also cause the lining of the uterus to thicken and increase blood supply to prepare for a possible pregnancy. The second phase of your cycle is called the ovulatory phase and starts around day 14. During this phase, a sudden surge in the hormones FSH and LH will cause the follicle to burst and eject the egg and any surrounding fluid into the abdomen. The egg is then caught by tiny little fingers at the end of the fallopian tube called fimbriae. Once the egg enters the fallopian tube, it's carried towards the uterus by gentle muscle contractions. Here, the egg will be either fertilized in the fallopian tube or it will travel to the uterus unfertilized, where it disintegrates and exits the body with the rest of the uterine lining. Once the egg has been released, the follicle will seal over. This is called the corpus luteum, and it's the start of the third and final phase of your cycle, called the luteal phase. During this phase, levels of FSH and LH drop suddenly, and the corpus luteum will begin to produce progesterone, which helps keep the uterine lining in place. This allows more time for a fertilized egg to securely attach to the uterine lining. If the egg hasn't been fertilized, the corpus luteum will disintegrate and progesterone levels will drop, signaling the body to menstruate. Now, when the cells start to break down, they release chemicals called prostaglandins. These hormone-like chemicals tell the muscles of the uterus to contract, which helps move tissue and blood out of the body. Now, a few things are happening during this phase that can muck up your IBS. First of all, progesterone is a muscle relaxant. Since your body uses muscle contractions called peristalsis to move poop through your gut, the relaxing effect of progesterone can make it much harder to go to the bathroom. So you might feel constipated right after ovulation when levels of progesterone are at the highest. Then, when the corpus luteum disintegrates, your progesterone levels will drop. This can sort of open the floodgates, so to speak, and you may get very sudden relief from your constipation. This is about the time your cells start to release prostaglandins. Now, apparently prostaglandins like to travel because they can end up in your intestines, your stomach, or your brain. No matter where they land, these little chemicals scream contract at the top of their tiny little lungs, which can lead to symptoms like diarrhea, nausea, and migraines. Super fun, right? Now that scientists have realized that the majority of people with IBS are women, they've started to investigate how our reproductive cycle impacts our systems. While the research is still in the early phases, studies are starting to show that many people with IBS react to the sudden drop in estrogen and progesterone specifically. This can increase constipation, diarrhea, and bloating, or your normal symptoms may become more intense than usual. Research has also shown that people who experience painful periods, called dysmenorrhea, are twice as likely to experience an increase in symptoms. I hope this video has shed some light on why your symptoms seem to get worse on your period. Remember, the more you know about your body, the easier it is to manage your IBS.